Well, today we'll be talking about justice and public service on the Bernie Hayes Show with John Bowman, President, St. Louis County Chapter, NAACP, today. Welcome back. I'm Bernie Hayes, and today's guest is a very, very dear friend, longtime friend, and a true public servant, the president of the St. Louis County branch of the NAACP, John Bowman. John, welcome back to the show.
Good morning, Bernie.
It's been a long time since you've been here.
Absolutely.
Well, so many things have happened. John, lay out your credentials. I mean, you're a businessman, you're a public servant, you've done so many, many things. And recently, you even assisted us here. You're now a consultant to the National Blues Museum also.
Absolutely.
So tell us, who is John Bowman?
Oh, my goodness. I'll say it started, back in the late 1970s. Mm-hmm. I was an employee for Chrysler Corporation. Believe it or not, Bernie, I was an electrician.
Really?
Okay. Yes.
And Freeman Bosley.
Right. And I grew into becoming a robotics programmer. While I was working on my college degrees, I got my master's and my business degree. At the same time, I was working for Chrysler Corporation. And I got involved in union politics as an alternate steward, defending the workers. And one of my mentors was a guy named Lou Moy. Probably heard of him before.
Very well. Not at auto workers.
Yes. And I became a part of the Coalition of Black Trade Unions.
Right. That's Lou Moy.
Yes.
Lou succeeded at Cliff Wilson.
Absolutely.
Yeah, sure.
He sure did. Mm-hmm. And from there, I became more involved with the needs of African-American equity, even in the union.
Yeah.
And so at some point, the bug hit me where I became more involved in local politics. I was elected as an alderman. And from there, I became a state representative. From there, I ended up going back into the union workforce, working mm-hmm. as an apprenticeship coordinator for the UAW, statewide apprenticeship coordinator.
Sure.
And I was targeting underserved communities, females, African Americans, trying to introduce them to non-traditional occupations mm-hmm. and providing them grant opportunities to go to school.
Wow.
And so I've always been a part of many organizations, as you know. Mm-hmm. And I was the vice president of St. Louis County NAACP, and we had a change that was requested from the national, which placed me as the president. Mm-hmm. And so that's where I'm at right now.
Okay.
I am the president of St. Louis County NAACP.
I want to get to the mission and your plan and outline for the St. Louis County NAACP, but let's go back, because while you were state rep, you wrote some pretty positive legislation. Tell us about your tenure as a state rep.
I am very pleased.
You did a lot of lawmaking there.
Yes, I am very pleased with the body of work that that I was allowed to do as a state representative that still has impact today.
Mm-hmm.
I sponsored legislation on financial literacy, where it was required to be taught in high school.
Okay.
Great. And I also sponsored legislation on women healthcare issues. Some of my family members suffered from certain health issues that I just decided to give more education and more attention towards.
Mm-hmm.
And on the labor side, I drafted the original minimum wage increase legislation.
Wow. Wow.
And so,
see, people ought to remember that. They must know that John Bowman did this, you know?
Yeah. In 2006, mm-hmm. we could not get it passed in the House, but we changed it over to a voter amendment.
Mm-hmm.
And we took it to the ballot, and we were able to get it passed.
Right.
And I included a cost of living increase in it, which was unusual at that time.
Wow. But it worked.
It worked.
Wow,
so every January for a while, that cost of living increase kicked in, which brought people, it constantly increased their minimum wage. Not to a living wage, but it was better than what it had been previously. And to revisit the financial literacy legislation, House Bill 1973, It's ironic, my daughter was in high school at that time. And the final year, it was put off to be implemented in 2006. And my daughter was graduating in 2008.
Wow.
So the bill came up, and she asked me one day, she says, "Hey, Dad, a lot of students at my school are saying that you have added another requirement to our curriculum before we can graduate." I said, "Trust me, in the long run, you'll appreciate it."
And I'm sure she does now. All of them did at the time.
Absolutely.
And John, I know you were vigorously fought against the closing of St. Louis County Hospital.
Yes.
And Homer G. Phillips Hospital.
Absolutely.
So as the president of the county NAACP, well, what's happening with health care? You know, what's up over the region? I mean, African Americans are suffering.
There's such a
disparity.
There's
no hospital beds north of Del Mar.
Yeah.
So any plans for the county chapter NAACP to associate itself with health care at all?
There are definitely disparities how we receive health care in the African American community that need to be addressed.
Sure.
I like you, Bernie, remember when we had St. Luke's hospitals and
oh, man.
And over on Pope and Newstead, we had hospitals. They have now attempted to replace those services with these urgent care facilities in our community, but it's not providing the long-term health care that we really need. Mm. Now, I will...
Well, urgent. They're not that urgent either, because if you suffer a heart attack on, say, in Northside, North St. Louis, it's not going to get there in time.
No, if you can't get to Barnes or Christian or one of those hospitals, and that's
time. You're dead.
You're dead, basically. I would like to give credit to my fraternity brother, Rick Stevens, who is the president over at Christian at 367 and 270.
Mm-hmm.
He is doing everything to try to expand health care in North County.
It's great. Right.
So Rick, he's a forward-thinking individual. I'm working with him.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully in his position, we can expand and provide more health care services in North County and in the inner ring of North City, because that's where it's needed the most.
Great. John, you didn't have to become president of the St. Louis County Charter, because I know how busy you are and you do so many things, especially in unit activities. But yet and still, you took the position. So what's your vision for the St. Louis County and NAACP?
I have been acting in that role since April.
Yeah.
And I have taken time to reorganize and bring the organization back to its original mission. For an organization that was founded in 1909, mm-hmm. and built up on fighting for individuals' voters' rights, equality, inclusion, discrimination, an organization that has been around for that period of time, it's important not to lose your identity and to hold on to the character and the mission of what the organization originally was founded up on.
Mm-hmm.
So I pretty much have taken us back and brought our focus back to where it originally should be, which is being a voice for the voiceless, making sure there are equitable opportunities in education, health care, economics. As you spoke to about one of the other things I accomplished when I was in the legislature, because I was a vice chairman of economic development for the state.
Bernie. Wow. I know you're a business person, too.
Yeah, and I brought a lot of dollars to the St. Louis region and economic growth. So in our community right now, and we constantly talk about what is known as the Delmar Divide, which is a reality.
Sure.
There has to be more investment in the community. As Jim would say, we were talking about Jim earlier.
Jim Buford.
Mm-hmm. Jim would say, poverty is the father of crime.
Wow.
And he was absolutely correct.
No doubt about it.
If you want to fix many of the ills in our community, whether it's education, health care, housing, you have to provide a true economic opportunity for the individuals that live in that region. Right. And right now, we are lacking in that area.
Okay. My guest is John Bowman. He's president of the St. Louis County branch of the NAACP. He and Adolphus Pruitt, St. Louis City, work very close together. We'll be getting into that, too. In the meantime, We're at the New Life Evangelistic Center. Our new address is 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri. But Reverend Larry Rice and his staff and assistants and volunteers are still trying to reopen 1411 Locust Street in downtown St. Louis. That was John Bowman last time he visited us. That's where the facility was. But we need your help and support because the same programs that were administered down there, help for the homeless, help for those in need of clothing and food, those who needed assistance and the utilities, those students, those provided, still here from this location, 2428 Woodson Road. But we need your help and support. And it's not a gift we're asking you for. We're asking you for to invest in the New Life Evangelistic Center. And the key word is new life, because when you invest in New Life Evangelistic Center, you're helping someone in desperate need. And every penny, every nickel, no money is too short. None is too small, because every dime invested in New Life helps someone. And you can do it through Post Office Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. Or online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter. That's one word, newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. At American Express, Visa card, MasterCard, Discover card, takes less than 2 minutes for that investment in New Life. Back with our guest, John Bowman, after this.
An epidemic of homelessness is sweeping throughout the United States of America. In city after city, people are ending up on the streets. Now, instead of feeling overwhelmed, as believers, we can do three things. We can give, we can volunteer, and we can pray. We can pray for the homeless refugees that we're finding in one city after another, all over the United States. So many people ending up out on the streets, and the hearts of so many are growing cold at this particular time and indifferent to the need. Jesus said, as oft as you've done it to the least of these, he said, even so you've done it unto me. When's the last time you've prayed for the homeless refugees in the United States of America, appearing in city after city, not only in major cities, but even smaller cities? So many people ending up out on the streets, even in resort areas, places you never think you'd find homeless people, they're there. Jesus said, foxes have holes and birds have nests, but he, the Son of Man, had nowhere to lay his head. Please pray for the refugees. Please pray for the homeless people in America, and pray for those that are on the front lines, the first responders, reaching out through Jesus Christ among the homeless and hurting, whether it's in Springfield or St. Louis. Your prayers and gifts to the New Life Evangelistic Center makes a big difference. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166.
2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has gone, the new has come.
Welcome back. John Bowman is my guest. He's the St. Louis County president of this. He's president of St. Louis County branch of the NAACP. And John, Bob Demler, our producer and director, asked about the different branches of the NAACP. I know you and Adolphus Pruitt work together. He's the St. Louis chapter branch, right. But there are many chapters in the series, in the area. Alton, East St. Louis.
Yeah, sure. St. Charles. Mm-hmm. And we are trying something that has not been done on a regular basis, usually, Bernie. Mm-hmm. We meet the East St. Louis branch president, Adolphus, who's president of St. Louis City, and the president of St. Charles, President Lenore.
Okay.
Because right now, I'm working with President Lenore in St. Charles on a racial profiling issue that happened on Highway 70. Wow. Because you can't get to St. Louis County or St. Louis City without coming through St. Charles County if you're coming from the West area.
Precisely.
So it's very important that we understand we can accomplish more together than working apart. Mm-hmm. This past Tuesday, Adolphus and I attended the St. Louis County Council Board meeting. And the issue is the collective bargaining agreement that the Fraternal Order Police has put together We had submitted a letter that included implicit bias language that would help bridge the issues with diversity for the black police officers.
Okay.
And I hear the conversation all the time from, and I, me coming from a union, I clearly understand how a collective bargaining agreement works.
Sure.
And fortunately, I come from a union, the UAW, where we embrace diversity and make sure that we represent people regardless of their religion, sexual orientation, gender, or race.
Okay.
That is what makes us a great union.
Right.
And I was trying to express that same thing to the Fraternal Order Police representatives that, and the St. Louis County, if you had this language in place, you would not be facing the $20 million lawsuit that they're facing now from the issue with the St. Louis County police officer.
Sure, the gender discrimination.
Yeah, because you could have gone to arbitration and cut that off long before it got that far.
Wow.
And that is why the jury foreman made the statement, we are going to levy the highest fine we possibly can to send out a message that we won't accept discrimination.
That's great. But I know you and Adolphus and B.T. Rice and others have been fighting the discrimination and the disparity in stopping black folks coming through Ladue and Creve Coeur in that area, and also through St. Charles, that corridor also there. So do you have any hope that your legislation and your voices will be heard and things will get better?
I've met with several of the new state legislators, and we plan to present legislation to them and in the format of one, to put some oversight on the police chases that go on through our community and is causing loss of life.
Sure.
And so there is some legislative language already in place. It doesn't have enough teeth to get the attention of the people that it needs to.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to work closely with people in the legislative body and the Senate to make it clear that we got to have eliminate this cavalier attitude toward the loss of life in our communities.
Wow. I know you also work very closely with Wesley Bell, the St. Louis prosecuting attorney.
Yes.
So how are you and he coalescing?
I am about to meet with Wesley about certain programs that I think will assist in some of the criminal reform efforts that he has in mind, including reentry job opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to sit down and also talk to him about bail reform and those type of issues. The NAACP National has a very aggressive legislative package that we plan to implement at the local level. And you mentioned Adolphus, and he and I are going to work closely together. The problem may vary somewhat from St. Louis City to St. Louis County, but the overall big picture problems are the same across the board, whether it's, whether it's East St. Louis, St. Charles County.
Driving while black.
Yeah, it is basically the same stuff. That's why we still have a travel advisory in Missouri right now, because the state conference, President Rod Chappell and the National decided if you all are going to keep putting these barriers and discriminatory practices in place, then we have to send a message out public saying that we're not accepting it.
And they document it, don't they? They even document the wrongdoings that they do.
They document it, but there's no real repercussion.
They know what they're doing and actually put it down in writing.
Yeah.
So you've got to come along and then find a remedy for all that wrongdoing.
I want to also mention, Bernie, one of the latest challenges I'm facing is the situation in Melville School District.
Okay.
This week, one of the educators took it up on herself to send a child home with a homework assignment related to marketplace value and commodities.
Yeah, wow.
Now, I can get the understanding of giving a clear understanding of how financial services work.
Yeah.
But I guarantee you, in the Normandy School District or Ferguson or Hazelwood School District, they would have found a better example to use than slavery.
Than slavery, yeah.
I mean, a fifth grade student is very impressionable. Mm. Those are very formidable years in their lives. And as adults, we have to use basic common sense.
Precisely.
This is not a real need to understand this through professional development. This is just a need to be sensitive to the fact that you're working in a diverse environment.
Common sense.
Common sense is basically all it is.
My guest is John Bowman, President, St. Louis County Branch NAACP. And if you notice that Mr. Bowman is drinking coffee out of a...
Yes, good coffee out of a Bernie Hayes mug. It's good coffee.
Reverend Larry Rice would like each and every one of you viewing us today to have a copy of this book. And here's Reverend Larry Rice to tell it to you.
The Bernie Hayes Program is produced at NLEC TV right here at 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri. It's our new headquarters since they closed the 1411 Locust building. We're working to get back into that building. In addition to that, trying to help so many people through a wide variety of safe houses, training programs, transportation assistance, so many ways people are getting help because of all of you that are supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. Now, if you'll send a gift of $25 or more, we want to send you this special, the Bernie Hayes Show Cup. And we're giving that to people as just a way of saying thank you. So when you send your gift, request a cup. We'll be happy to get it off to you. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. You can give online at nlecstl.org. Now I'm really asking all of you to join us in praying. The needs are so phenomenal at this particular time. So many hurting and homeless people are contacting us daily, but we're able to help them because of each one of you that are praying, caring, and sharing at this time. Tell your family, certain friends about NLEC TV and get directly involved yourself.
We'll return to, I guess, after this Black History Moment. Dr. Milana Karanga, Professor of Africana Studies at California State University, Long Beach, was a holder of two PhDs. Karanga completed his degrees in political science at United States International University and in social ethics at the University of Southern California before being awarded an honorary doctorate from the University of Durban, South Africa. Karanga's fields of teaching and research with African America and Black Studies included ancient Egyptian ethics, African intellectual history, ethnic relations, and socioeconomic ethical thought of Malcolm X. A prolific writer, Karanga authored numerous scholarly articles and books, including Maat, The Moral Ideal of Ancient Egypt, A Study of Classical African Ethics, The Book of Coming Forth by Day, and the Ethics of a Declaration of Innocence, and Introduction to Black Studies. Milana Karanga, curator of the Pan-African holiday Kwanzaa, is our guest.
Now you can take NLEC TV anywhere as you put the NLEC TV app on your iPhone or mobile device. NLEC TV is an innovative TV station that's on the cutting edge of community service. When you tune in to NLEC TV, you'll discover a television station that has been operated by previously homeless individuals who've received broadcast training through New Life Evangelistic Center's unique on-the-job training program. On NLEC TV, you'll discover wholesome family, community, renewable energy, and inspirational programming. Those needing energy assistance, food, clothing, or freedom from the cycle of homelessness will find that plus much more on NLEC TV. Now, you can receive NLEC TV by going to 24.2 on your television set or putting the NLEC TV app on your iPhone or mobile device. For further information, call 314-436-2424 or go to nlecstl.org. That's nlecstl.org.
2 Timothy 1, verse 10.
But it has now been revealed through the appearing of our Savior, Jesus Christ, who has destroyed death and has brought life and immortality to light through the gospel.
Welcome back. I'm so pleased to say that my guest is the president of the St. Louis County branch at NAACP, Mr. John Bowman. And John, you've done so much. You've done so many things and you continue to do so many things. And your agenda is pretty progressive, is it not?
It is extremely progressive. Yes. It's just a part of my DNA. Mm-hmm. But I grew up around giants, including you.
Oh, thank you.
I have the utmost respect for. Mm-hmm. And watching the commitment and the passion that certain leaders in our community have shown, sacrifices, I feel it is my duty to walk in the path that made a clear path for me, because there were some people who took time to guide me, advise me in ways that they didn't have to, and I feel it's my duty to do the same.
Right. And you and Mike McMillan, the Urban League, are very dear friends.
Yeah, I've known Mike for a long time.
Yeah, sure. So, and the Urban League and the NAACP are not in conflict. Actually, you work in unison, don't you?
Oh, we
especially in Ferguson, aren't they?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, no, sure. There's no conflict. Mm-hmm. We have, I mean, perfect alignment.
Yeah, sure. Mike, I mean, there's no competition. I mean, you actually.
No. Sure. I tell you, there are enough issues for all of us to share.
Sure. Yeah.
And then to come together once again, the Urban League under Mike's leadership, as the previous leader Jim Buford did, is in alignment with what our community needs. The NAACP, we are probably a more discriminatory-focused, discrimination-type organization, while Mike and Urban League does a great job with providing training opportunities and then speak to the issues in our community that needs to be spoke to. So, no, there's no competition. We're in alignment.
We're in alignment, yeah. And I know that you personally played a part in Ferguson. You were very much against what was happening in Ferguson. Yes. And John Bowman, you're on the streets out there too. Tell us about your involvement and what you hope to do now with Ferguson.
Yeah, absolutely. It was a tragic situation. When that occurred, actually, believe it or not, I was in Birmingham, Alabama the day it happened, and I was watching on TV, and I was thinking, wow, ironically, I'm in Birmingham, and St. Louis is looking like that.
Sure.
But when I came back,
like Birmingham looked in the 60s.
Right. So that Monday, as soon as I got back, I went down to Ferguson City Hall and wanted to see the mayor and the chief of police to explain there was some real problems here. And I spent time with Ron Johnson in the streets of Ferguson when we were trying to bring some calm to certain situations. But the same
with state police.
Yes. He was Captain Ron Johnson at that time. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, making sure
Missouri State Police,
correct. Sure. Mm-hmm. Making sure that the protesters were being able to be heard and understanding the emotional anger that was felt for that situation. So since that time, I have tried to stay close to the leadership over there, working with some of the Board of Aldermen, including working on Wesley's campaign when he.
Sure. Wesley Bell,
when he ran for.
I hate to interrupt you, but we have not let people know how to reach you.
Oh.
And now's the time to do that, I think. How can you be reached?
All right, so we can be reached at NAACP St. Louis County office. It's located at 26 North Oaks Plaza in the professional building.
Okay.
And our phone number is 314-322-4441. You can email me at jbowman@naacpstlouiscounty.org.
Okay. And you have a website?
Yes, our website is NAACP St. Louis County at NAACP St. Louis County.
And you're also on Facebook?
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. We have NAACP St. Louis County.org.
Okay.
Yes.
This is great. So once again, put that phone number up for us.
314-899-0033.
899-0033. Okay, St. Louis County branch
NAACP. Yes,
sir. John Bowman, once again, you know, you've been so supportive of the New Life Evangelistic Center, and I just want to thank you. And you've been a supporter of mine for years and years and years. I want to thank you personally, John.
Thank you. Thank you, Bernie.
So much. And thank you for appearing with us at the National Blues Museum, too, because you and Adolphus Pruitt mean a lot to us. Thank you so much.
Thank you
for viewing us, too, and to continue to support the New Life Evangelistic Center. We're 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri, 63114. I'm Bernie Hayes. Have a great day.